In this section, we will look at overview of ISDN. What is ISDN? Integrated Services Digital Network. We will look at why ISDN is required. Then we'll get on to ISDN basics and ISDN services. We'll deal with both these aspects extensively. After that, we'll get into the network details. We'll look at ISDN interfaces, ISDN channels, ISDN functional grouping, and the reference points that are part of an ISDN network. Finally, we'll round it off with a overview of broadband ISDN and ISDN architecture. Over to ISDN now. Why do we need ISDN? To answer that, let's look at the advantages of ISDN. It is a high-speed service. The data speed can be from 12 kilobits per second up to 2048 kilobits per second. ISDN brings in cost advantage. Low cost results due to reduced retransmission of information, fast information transfer, simplified network management and maintenance, multiple services through a single network, and so on. It's a high quality transmission. ISDN, being an all digital transmission, has excellent and reliable quality. Simultaneous transmission also is possible. ISDN can perform simultaneous function and support multiple services at the same time. Conferencing is another important feature of ISDN. ISDN can handle several calls at once or conference them together with just one number. ISDN supports call management features such as call forwarding, call pickup, message waiting indicator, direct invert dialing, and so on. That is why ISDN is such an important service. Let us have a brief overview of ISDN in this slide. Let's look at the ISDN basics. What is ISDN? It stands for Integrated Services Digital Network or Isolated Subscriber Digital Network. ISDN is a circuit switched end-to-end digital transmission standard. It supports digital transmission of voice and data over ordinary telephone copper wires, which results in better voice quality than an analog phone. This is the first ever digital switching network, all digital switching network. It offers circuit switched connections at 64 kilobits per second or increments of 64 kilobits per second, normally known as N into 64 kilobits per second. It also provides internet services at a maximum of 128 kilobits per second. It can also support video conference at 64 kilobits or increments of 64 kilobits such as 128, 256, 384, and so on. ISDN in reality is a set of protocols for establishing and releasing circuit switch connections with advanced call features for the users. The special feature of ISDN is it supports two simultaneous connections in any combinations of data, voice, video, fax over a single copper line. Multiple devices can be attached to the line and used as and when needed. These services fall under three categories: bearer services, supplementary services, and teleservices. With ISDN, all customers will become digital rather than analog. What are the standards? ISDN technology is of course standardized according to recommendations of CCITT, now known as ITU, which describe the protocols and architectures to implement a worldwide digital communication network. Two standards in particular are SG11, ISDN and telephone network switching and signaling, SG18, digital networks including ISDN. Now let us look at some of the familiar ISDN terms. First, basic rate interface. This is an entry level interface in ISDN. Basic rate interface known as BRI is offered at 144 kilobits per second over the copper wires. The 144 kilobits consists of two 64 kilobits bearer channels plus one 16 kilobits data channel, 2B plus D. The basic rate interface is made up of 2B channels plus 1D channels as we have just now seen. The B channels are at 64 kilobits and can be used for voice and data communications. The D channel at 16 kilobits is used for call initialization and signaling connections. BRI is used for computer connections. Let's now look at PRI, Primary Rate Access. This is one more ISDN service available and this is called PRI. This is an E1 PCM MUX at 2 megabits. As we know already, E1 is a 30B channels of 64 kilobits and 1D channel in the time slot TS16, which is also of 64 kilobits, and a synchronization channel TS0 that is also at 64 kilobits. 30B channels, 1D channel and one synchronization channel. North America and Japan use a different standard called T1, which is at 1544 kilobits per second. T1 has got a frame structure of 23B channels and 1D channel, which is meant for signaling. What are the two types of ISDN that we know of? One is narrowband ISDN, other one is broadband ISDN. Narrowband ISDN carries up to 64 kilobits per second, ranging up to T1 rates, sometimes used to refer to regular telephone and non-video capable systems. Whereas broadband ISDN, the communication standards being developed by the ITU to handle the high bandwidth applications such as video. BISDN will use ATM technology over SONET based transmission units to provide data rates typically of the order of 155 megabits per second to 622 megabits per second and perhaps beyond. In this slide, let's look at ISDN services. ISDN services generally fall into three categories. They are bearer services, teleservices and supplementary services. Please refer figure which brings out the differentiation between conventional PSTN switching and ISDN switching. What is bearer service? Bearer service offers the capability to transfer digital voice and non-voice services using ISDN standard. We have seen bearer service in detail in the earlier part of this series. Bearer service provides the means to transfer information, which could be voice, data and video, between users through circuit switching or packet switching or cell switching or frame switching. The network does not need to process information. OSI layers 1, 2 and 3 belong to this. The bearer channel's basic rate is 64 kilobits per second. What is teleservices? In teleservices, the network may change the contents by processing it. OSI layers 4, 5, 6 and 7 belong to this, where the transformation of the contents do take place. For example, error bits are added. Examples of teleservices are telephony, telefax, videofax, etc. Then what is supplementary services? These provide additional functionality to the bearer service and teleservices. Supplementary services include call waiting, reverse charging, message handling, caller ID, and so on.